Good evening. Residents along the Hawkesbury are again facing an uncertain few days, with thousands of people today given their evacuation orders. This is a live look at Wiseman's Ferry tonight, the latest community ordered to higher ground.
Elsewhere, the clean-up is underway from the Nepean all the way to Lismore, where many fear they will never truly rebuild. Still, those stories of hope continue to emerge as a family's reunited with their pet dog days after it disappeared on floodwaters. And tonight, there are fresh warnings. Any reprieve won't last long, with another storm front headed our way.
This is today's reality for residents living on the Hawkesbury.
There's no in and out. It's sit and wait.
Not in the house yet, but for some Wiseman's Ferry residents, the water's lapping at their doors. And for Mitchell Brennan, it was a trudge up his flooded street just to get there.
And just try and keep everything dry. See what we can save.
With waters easing at North Richmond and Windsor, the giant flood mass is moving downstream, swallowing parts of Cumberland Reach, Lower Portland and Wiseman's Ferry. There, evacuations began today.
We got hit pretty bad last year and we've rebuilt and we're just trying to save as much as we can on the second time.
With a moderate flood warning in place, it was a race against time, the water cutting routes in and out.
Everyone's evacuated up there, so there's no one in there, but we'll get to the road and just have a look.
But not everyone is leaving. Some want to stay. For them, this is part of river life.
It's a different community up here. They really look after each other, look after themselves, and some of them are so well prepared that they're able to ride it out.
The SES is on hand, dropping supplies and checking on those still guarding their homes. Cabins in these caravan parks turned to islands.
The river is moving at a fast pace through this area. As you can see, it is full of debris and it's isolating people in their homes. It is expected to peak today, but it will be another several days before the water goes back down.
The rivers are very high, fast flowing. There's a lot of debris and it's very dangerous out there.
As the sun finally cracked through the Sydney cloud line today, reminders everywhere the situation is still very live, including this landslide at Galston. The system responsible for all the trouble made landfall in the Hunter late yesterday. The giant low weakened and vanished, the severe weather warning cancelled. But forecasters are now warning of round two, a new low developing on Sunday and Monday.
Now that is not good news for us here in eastern New South Wales and for much of the state, as we know things are already saturated.
But one thing never dampened, the community's fighting spirit, still standing, proud and tall.
Live now to Miley Hogan in the Hawkesbury. Miley, all eyes right now on that system due in on Sunday.
Well, Ange, with the rivers already so full and the ground soaked, the Bureau is warning that more heavy falls could lead to prolonged, moderate and major flooding, particularly around the Hawkesbury Nepean. One good thing, the SES is saying that after last year's flood, Sydneysiders are more prepared this time. They had 700 call-outs overnight and 13 flood rescues, far fewer than they were expecting. It's hoped that people will stay prepared and vigilant with this new system heading this way. Ange.
Okay, Miley, thank you.
All right, let's get the latest from further upstream. Tom Hartley's our reporter in Windsor. Tom, good evening. Is the water receding yet?
Well, Michael, it is, but it's happening incredibly slowly. I should really emphasise that. I mean, it's at 11.6 metres right now. It's at 11.7 metres all of this morning, sitting really steadily, having peaked just below the major flood level at 2:30 this morning. So that gives you an indication how slow this water is receding. Locals, they just want to see it gone, knowing that things could go horribly wrong if they get that extreme rainfall over the next 48 to 72 hours. They're basically now left to relive the hell that they went through last year. Welcome to Groundhog Day at Windsor, where roads are once again waterways. Riverside blocks, streets, businesses are somewhere under all of this.
We're pretty much almost over your farm.
Yeah, over the farm as we speak, yeah. It's about 8.5 metres deep.
What's it like to see it like this again?
Oh, it's just heartbreaking, you know, just to think we've had to rebuild it all and, you know, now we've got to do it all again.
Their sprawling green fields, their livelihoods, this is where more than a third of Australia's turf comes from.
It's just like an ocean, you know, as far as you can see.
It's the same from the sky all along the Hawkesbury, Nepean and its tributaries, a stormwater sea surrounding, isolating and cutting off communities, wiping out roads, power lines and vital infrastructure.
It's hard to say at this point when we'll have access again, so we've still got our community divided.
So we've cut the engine, we're now just drifting on the Hawkesbury River, and you can see and feel just how powerful the water is, the force of it all, and just how fast we're moving. On one side you've got Pitt Town, on the other side that's Wilberforce, where the trees are, that's usually the river banks, but now you can just see how far the water goes.
Upriver, one landmark the whole region's been watching, Windsor Bridge. The water peaking here at 11.9 metres, below the initial prediction by a couple of metres, still causing catastrophic damage, but sparing some homes that could have otherwise gone under.
I sold this house to my son last time. After I got out last time, I sold it to him, so I'm a bit smarter than the young bloke.
We're not past the danger period yet.
There's still a lot of water in these catchments and they would take quite a while to slowly fall.
Though that system's moved away, scattered showers are still taunting the region. Put simply, more rain means a prolonged peak and a prolonged recovery.
We need the state and federal government to either get on board and help us project manage this infrastructure, or to give us the funding to actually go and employ project manager and infrastructure staff. Deliver the work.
All us boys will get in together and get it back up and running, and we'll, you know, hopefully keep going.
Knowing full well they will flood again, it's just a matter of when. Tom Hartley, 7 News.
The water has mostly receded in western Sydney, but residents are still on high alert with fears the Warragamba dam spill could spark another emergency. Tom Saker is at Wallacea. Tom, residents have been given a fierce warning.
Yeah, that's right. There's certainly the message from authorities today was do not get complacent. There are countless thousands here in the Nepean Hawkesbury River who are at risk of the Warragamba Dam spilling once again. It is just 4 kilometres in that direction. It has, the spill rate has gone under 100 gigalitres again today, but that doesn't mean that they're out of the woods and they're in the exact same position that they were about 48 hours ago, anticipating more floodwaters over the next few days. The warning, stay alert. The cleanup begins in Shane's Park, hosing mud off floors and walls. A familiar routine after a deluge, but one Suzette Turner can't get her head around.
It's not just a picture, it's not just a news report, it's not a photo. This is our lives and it's devastating. Like, it's horrible.
Yesterday, Suzette, her family and her pets were rescued from their homes, a Noah's Ark moment of triumph. Today, trying to reassure them it was safe for the time being.
Come on, let's go.
But it also came with a message from local police that surrounding roads were still closed for fears of another big spill over the Warragamba Dam wall, and it was back to panic stations.
So the police have just come and told us to stop cleaning up, that they're going to release Warragamba Dam and we're going back under. We've just heard this probably about 15 minutes ago.
The SES said the spill rate peaked at 3 a.m. this morning at 315 gigalitres per day.
The situation around Sydney is by far from over.
By mid-morning, it had slowed dramatically to 128 gigalitres, but new flood warnings for Sydney were issued by the Bureau of Meteorology at 2 p.m.
And some people haven't probably understood that we actually do have major flood levels on these rivers.
When there are evacuation orders in place, please leave. Please don't drive through floodwaters.
But like in so many communities, fatigue and frustration is setting in.
We've asked and asked for help and reasons why we keep getting flooded over and over.
We can't do everything, but nevertheless, we need more state and federal government support to ensure that people are really looked after.
In Penrith, Jess Fox said it was deja vu. The Whitewater Centre still too wet, even for the world's best canoeist. Tom Saker, 7 News.
A fifth person is confirmed dead on the north coast, a man in his 40s, found near Mwillimbah this afternoon. It came as the government promised an emergency response team of 400, overseen by a new floods minister. But Lismore locals say they need action right now.
In the antique trade, they say one person's trash is another's treasure. Well, these antiques are really trash now. Adam Bailey's collection of over 40 years. Just rubbish. $500,000 in stock destroyed, despite much of it being in a loft well above ground level.
Well, you can see up here, quarter way up those windows there was the 2022.
You'd hope some can be saved. A child's rocking horse and historic roll of honour. The rest, ruined.
All the furniture we thought we might be able to save, it's got mould on it now and it's just all got to be thrown out.
Truckloads of troops rolled into Lismore today, 70 so far, but more are coming. They were busy helping out at Simone Dixon's store. She's one of many salt traders who fear this is the end.
I don't know whether we're going to be able to get back on our feet. I just don't know.
The offices at the Koorie Mail, Australia's only Indigenous newspaper, have been destroyed.
We were affected really badly this time around. 30 years of the Koorie Mail has literally been washed away.
It's worse up north. Mullumbimby resident Ella Bancroft says people are cut off by landslides, no food, no fuel, no power and no help.
We have no support from government organisations hitting on the ground right now.
Further south, a promise of support.
Ensuring that every single person gets through this difficult time.
Emergency Services Minister Steph Cook will also become the Minister for Flood Recovery.
And I'll absolutely give it my level best every single day.
While the Premier visited Ballina today, tomorrow is when he'll have the time to see Lismore, a city that is begging for government support but is yet to see it.
Please, this time, please can the government help a little more, Lismore, this time. Many places missed out in 2017 and this is so much worse.
In Lismore, Bill Hogan, 7 News.